Hello and welcome to another video of the TeamUp 5G series. My name is Ilias Nektarios Eitanidis and I am ESR10 from International Hellenic University, Greece. Today's presentation is entitled Random Access at a Glance. The context of today's presentation includes introduction. We will see the random access types. The two RATS types, contention-free random access and contention-based random access. We will see RACH-less, some grant-free SIMs, and finally, the conclusions. In human-type communications, the number of devices is relatively low, for example, less than 100 devices in a cell. Those devices are not meant to generate and transmit data to the cloud. So, the demand of uplink resources is low. Moreover, those devices are equipped with large capacity batteries and it's easy to recharge them, for example, a phone. The service types of HTC networks are limited, so across the network, all the devices share the same service types. On the contrary, in 5G networks, there is a vast amount of deployed devices, much more than 100 devices in a cell, which generate and transmit data to the cloud with various payload sizes. So, the demand of uplink resources is big. One example of 5G scenario is smart cities. In smart cities, the devices deployed, in general, are powered by batteries, with a requirement of long intervals between maintenance. So, the power consumption is of paramount importance. As we can see on the figure, there are three main service types, EMBB, URLLC, and MMTC, all with different quality of service requirements. All these services have to coexist in the same network. In this context, the need for efficient use of uplink resources is very important. Let's consider a few hundreds of devices in a given area that want to transmit their data. The synchronization with the base station alone produces a lot of overhead on the network, consuming valuable resources from the data transmission. This figure roughly demonstrates the process for a typical data transmission. The UE receives the basic system information from the base station, proceeds in synchronization and then transmits the actual data. The two access types that we consider are random access channel, RATS based, and RATS-less solutions, which we will discuss in the following slides. RATS is a sequence of steps that have to be performed between the UE and the base station. The 5G NR RATS procedure is very similar to the LTE RATS. There are two types of RATS. Contention-based. In contention-based random access, the UE selects a preamble randomly from a pool of preambles shared with the other UEs. This means that two UEs may select the same preamble, which may result to a conflict and unsuccessful random access. The base station uses a contention resolution mechanism to handle this type of access requests. This type is also known as a four-step RATS procedure. Contention-free. In contention-free based random access, the preamble is allocated by the base station, and such preambles are known as dedicated random access preambles. The dedicated preamble is provided to the UE either via the radio resource control signaling or the physical layer signaling. For this reason, there is no preamble conflict, unlike the contention-based random access. This type is known as a three-step RATS procedure. If there are not enough resources available for the UE, then the base station suggests to the UE to use a contention-based random access. In a four-step contention-based random access type, the UE randomly selects a random access preamble from a pool of preambles shared with the other UEs. Upon selection, the UE performs a random access preamble transmission. Once the random access preamble is transmitted, the UE waits for the acknowledgement from the base station in the form of a random access response. The UE monitors for random access response over the physical downlink shared channel by attempting to detect a downlink control information format 1 message within a window configured by the parameter array response window defined in the system information block message. If the random access response contains a MAC sub PDU with a rapid equal to the transmitted preamble ID, then the random access response reception is considered from the UE as a success. At this point, we have to note that if more than one UEs have selected the same random access preamble, they are going to receive exactly the same random access response from the base station. Then the UE sends uplink scheduling information over the physical uplink shared channel with the uplink grant received from the random access response in the radio resource control message. Finally, the base station replies with the contention resolution message. If the received contention resolution identity matches with the transmitted identity, the UE declares that contention resolution was achieved and the random access procedure was successful. If there is no contention resolution identity received within 4 milliseconds, the UE considers that the contention resolution was not successful. The third generation partnership project in Release 16 introduced a two-step random access type. The need for this new random access type originated from the need to reduce both the time required for the UE to receive a random access response and the time required for the base station before transmitting a contention resolution message compared to the four-step random access type. As the name indicates, we have only two steps. The first message is the message A from the UE to the base station and includes the random access preamble transmission and the radio resource control connection message. The second message is the message B from the base station to the UE and includes the random access response and the contention resolution message. The new two-step random access type not only reduces the latency involved in the overall random access procedure, but also reduces the control signaling overhead. In contention-free random access, unlike the contention-based random access type, the UE uses a dedicated preamble provided by the base station, specifically for this UE, via the radio resource control signaling or physical downlink control channel, represented in our figure as the random access preamble assignment message. In this way, the risk of conflicts among users in the selection of preamble is eliminated. Then, the UE performs a random access preamble transmission. And finally, we have the random access response from the base station to the UE. The two-step contention-free random access is similar to the contention-based random access. However, in the two-step contention-free random access type, upon receiving message B, the UE ends the random access procedure. Moreover, In the contention-free random access type, if the random access procedure within the two-step procedure is not completed after a number of message A transmissions, in RACH-less, the number of the exchanged messages is much less, which leads to a reduced signal overhead. The base station sends a resource configuration message for the upcoming uplink transmission. Then, the UE transmits the actual data payload alongside with the preamble and the control information required. There are some benefits of using a RACH-less grant-free approach over a RACH-based grant-free solution. Firstly, the UE transmits without the need of resource allocation or grant allocation. Due to the minimalistic approach of the messages exchanged, the signal overhead is significantly reduced compared to the RACH approach. In addition, this leads to a better energy efficiency, given that the radio on time is reduced. Moreover, several UEs can use the same time and frequency resources efficiently. In general, RACH-less grant-free approaches are suitable for scenarios where the data are transmitted sporadically, for example, one message every 40 minutes, which is the case for MMTC services. Here we will see some of the grant-free SIMs, either RACH-based or RACH-less, that are being used in NOMA networks. Multiple access signature-based SIMs are contention-based and they use a multiple access signature for differentiating from the other user's signal. The signature may be pre-configured or randomly selected and it's based on interleave or spreading or scrambling. Compute and forward-based SIMs are based on the linear structures. In this approach, the network is converted to a set of reliable linear equations. The UE encodes the message with two channels, one error and correction and one user detection, with the last being selected in such a way that guarantees that the sum of distinct code words is unique. Finally, compressive sensing identifies the active users of a slot by exploiting the number of the active users over the total users. As it exploits the small number of active users, it is the perfect candidate for MMTC uplink grant-free use cases. Grant-free approaches, and especially NOMA, have gained a lot of attention, and there is a lot of ongoing research from both academia and industry. The most important questions for future work in grant-free approaches are: should it be a RACH-based approach or a RACH-less approach? Even if we consider that each UE has a unique sequence, if the number of UEs is big, then the assignment of unique sequences to each user is not practical and may lead to collisions. Regarding the resource partitioning, should it be randomly? Should it be by the user? Or should it be pre-configured by the base station? Efficient link adaptation regards the condition of the radio link. Link adaptation is mostly based on the channel state information. The UE has to make sure that the channel is not altered, or if it's altered, to correctly modify. Thank you for your attention.